session. So, Han Reine himself was working for Yle, the Finnish broadcasting company, for a number of decades actually, as a distinguished journalist. And he's, at the moment, he's an independent writer, an independent journalist. As far as I'm concerned, perhaps the person who is the best expert on Israel-Palestine from the Finnish commentators. So it's my pleasure to welcome Han Reine.
Terms like colonization and colonial settler state are no longer politically correct, as they were 100 years ago, as they were between up until the Second World War during the 20th century. That's why so-called supporters of Israel have so energetically tried to distort the image of the reality on the ground. That's also why Roman Finkelstein has been so subjected to harsh attacks. He's not alone in this. But his case is the most bizarre one. That Finkelstein was refused the continuation of his tenure at DePaul University in Chicago. There were attempts to pressure the publisher not to put out his latest book, Beyond Chutzpah. Fortunately, the publisher at the University of California Press didn't fall to the pressure. Let me add that the term supporters of Israel should be enclosed within thick quotation marks. In the words of Noam Chomsky, what these people are in fact supporting is Israel's moral degeneration and its ultimate destruction. Although Palestinians are the immediate victims of this conflict, what is at stake in the longer view is the future of Israeli Jews. I think this point was most perceptively formulated by people the small radical Matzvein group in Israel after the June War of 1967. They stated that the questions of refugees, borders, and the future of Palestinian Arabs are only several aspects and manifestations of the central problem, the future of Israel in a predominantly Arab region. Besides the Israel-Palestine conflict itself, another aspect of Norman Finkelstein's scholarship has been the political and cultural repercussions of the conflict in the West, and especially in his own country, the United States. This is the topic of his book, The Holocaust Industry, Reflections on the Exploitation of Jewish Suffering, which came out in 2000. The book's title is very provocative, but here again, it's important to remember that the difference between reality and ideological use is made of it. In this case, the reality is the Nazi Holocaust industrial mass murder of European Jews. The image is the use of Holocaust and anti-Semitism in support of Israel's action in the Middle East. When I was reading The Holocaust Industry, the thing which most surprised me was Finkelstein's description of how little such topics as Jewish history and the suffering of the Jews, Holocaust and Israel, were discussed in the United States before the war of 1967. The memory of Holocaust and even interest in Israel were taken to be left-wing courses by and large. The U.S.-Israeli strategic partnership started after the June War of 1967, when Israel defeated the surrounding Arab armies. It was more than a military defeat. It was the defeat of secular Arab nationalism, potentially the most threatening challenge to Western imperialist domination of the Middle East and ultimately its oil. That's why the United States started to support Israel in the massive scale it has done since then, not because Israel is weak, but because Israel is strong. Israel is the largest American aircraft carrier in the world, which cannot be sunk, as the former Secretary of State and the commander of NATO's forces, General Alexander Haig, has formulated the matter. In this context, it is ideologically useful to present Israel as a potential victim whose Jewish population is threatened with a new Holocaust. If I understand Norman Finkelstein's studies correctly, this is the main reason for the phenomenon that he calls the Holocaust Industry. For this aspect of his work, he has been attacked even more harshly than for his studies on the Israel-Palestine conflict itself. So to conclude, and before giving floor to Dr. Finkelstein, I would like to appeal to authorities. I don't like the argument from authority, but two very respected scholars, namely Israeli-British historian Avi Schleim and the late Ralph Hilbert, who was the most important research on the Holocaust, who wrote the three-volume issue, The Destruction of European Jews. They both have praised Dr. Finkelstein's work. So, by this verse, I invite Dr. Finkelstein here. The floor is yours.